His tools are, for the most part, his hands, and he had raw material aplenty, beach sand. Billy Rimmer, who hails from Southport near Liverpool, England, began working on his sandcastle project yesterday and intends to leave a work of art on the local beach when he's done.
Average is 2 or 3 days, but then for every day it stays where it is. You can just add to them and make them bigger. So they can take as long as 2 weeks, depending on if nobody jumps on them or if the sea washes them away.
The British visitor's work has drawn the admiration of many beach goers, both foreigners and locals alike. They feel he's a wise man, even though he's building on the sand.
When I saw this guy came along the beach, said he want to build a sandcastle, I say, oh my God, what is this guy thinking? But when I saw him start working and start to build that sandcastle, I found that was a great guy and a great job he's doing. Because people can come and actually come see what this guy is doing. And he's not finished as yet, but it seems to me he knows what he's doing.
Yesterday I see the man pass with 2 buckets. I think the man was doing something like a puppy show. So this morning when I came, I see that and I see everybody saying, hey, the man do a castle there. And I very like it, whatever. I never see it like that before. So I'm so happy to see it by the Rex Saint Lucian, where I'm a vendor selling.
Billy Rimmer says he learned the art of sandcastling from a Hungarian whom he met in Spain. The Hungarian, he disclosed, has been building sandcastles for most of his life. But Mr. Rimmer admits that his is a delicate undertaking, which can be destroyed in seconds by the rise of the tide, heavy wind, rainfall, or careless people.
I've been walking back towards my sculpture before after going to the shop and watched some kids jump off onto the top of them. And like you say, so many hours and a few seconds to destroy them here.
The British visitor is here on vacation. He says he loves St. Lucia and came here for kite surfing. It's obvious that of the traditional sun, sand and sea that the island has to offer, his preference is the sand. For the DBS News World, Alex Buske reporting.